is that? Oh yeah. In. Oh no, look at this. Oh boy. This is halfway through. Well, as you can
hopefully appreciate, I've had a bit of an ordeal getting into the woods. Decided to come in a slightly different route, but with the recent storms, everything's been trashed in the woods, and lots of dead wood and bramble and all sorts is blocking the path. A bit of an ordeal getting in, but I'm just going to scout through the woodland now, look for a potential camp spot. I've got a few camp spots that I visit regularly in this woodland, so I might have to go and use one of my old camp spots again. But I know it's a good camp spot, that. But if I find anything decent on the way in, then I may go for that. Let's have a look. Well, that's the shelter set up. I've got to put the stove in, but I'll do that in a little while. Facing south, and we've got a cold north easterly wind coming into camp, and temperatures currently are around about +1, +2°C, which is about 32-33°F. But they're predicted to become -2, which is about 17, -2, whatever that is in Fahrenheit anyway. And then with the wind chill, possibly down to -8. And I know what that is, that's 17°F. There you go, look, I've done my sums. I've got a different sleep system I'm going to be trying tonight, and I'll show you that in a little while. But I've not had no breakfast, and then now we're well into the sort of like mid-afternoon. I'm getting really hungry, so I'm going to cook myself something up, just a snack for now, to tide me over, and then I've got my main food to cook later on this afternoon, this evening. So that's what I'm going to do. Still a lot to do to come. I've got to source wood, get the stove in, get myself all set up for the night, check my hurricane lamps over. So a lot to do still, but anyway, let's get the stove going. So the brainwave, but the I brought my nesting MSR pots out with me. I like these pots very much, but the lid of the pot is a good fit on my frying pan, so it's keeping the heating. I'm pleased with that. Give the old sausages a quick stir. I'm really looking forward to these. I'm really hungry. I think they're done. Got some nice piri piri extra sauce someone sent me as a gift. I don't remember who sent it to me now. Anyway, whoever it was, thanks very much if you're watching. Let's get these sausages. I think they're done. Look at that. Maybe I'll just try a little bit of the hot sauce. It's quite thick. Food always tastes better outdoors. I can feel that. Taste that sauce. Well, that piri piri sauce has been lovely. I love that. Very, very nice. Anyway, that's the first course done. I think I'm going to get myself a brew on. I need I could really do with a cup of coffee now. So that's what I'm going to do. and losing the light. This time of year we've still got quite short hours of daylight really, and I need to get some wood, so we'll put the rucksack on my back and then making my way through the woodland to where that pine tree was. I think I'm gonna harvest some of that wood from the wood burner. Certainly a lot easier walking through the woodland with a backpack on rather than having to push the wheelbarrow. I got myself a pretty good haul of firewood. It's nice and dry. I don't know how long it's going to burn because it's pretty low grade pine, so it might go quite quick. Anyway, I know where they can come back to if I need any more. It's a good old haul, that. time to get the old stove set up. I brought my titanium Woodswalker stove with me, but I just remembered I've bought also a trail camera, so I'm going to just quickly go over to around there as a game trail, set a trail camera up, and we might be lucky to see some wildlife tonight during the camp.
This is a game trail. Deer, there's loads of deer sign all along here. So I'm going to stick the camera on the tree and see if we can record any images during the camp.
So this is the game trail. They come all the way along here, and there's loads of sign of deer. I can see a distinct track, and down here on the ground we've got a scraping where an animal's recently lain, probably a roe deer. There's lots of roe deer, but it could also be a muntjac, so we'll see. But anyway, let's just turn the camera on. That's looking good. Okie doke, I think we'll just leave it. Yeah, that's it, it's arming itself now. By the way, in the last 28 days, I've had over 3,000 new subscribers. So if you like what you see on the channel and you're enjoying the content, please feel free to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. Thanks very much. I'm losing the light really fast. I know as soon as the sun goes down, it's setting now. As soon as it goes down below the horizon, it's going to get really cold. Temperature's going to drop. Get the stove quickly set up, then I can generate some warmth within the shelter. Interested, I always run a little base plate in the bottom of the stove, because that's I think the bit of the stove which you're going to wear out the fastest perhaps. I've had this stove 2 years now, and I put that little bit of stainless steel in the base just to give it a little bit of protection. really losing the light now. Quick shout out to Neil from Greencraft, YouTube channel called Greencraft. I've been following him for a few months now. He's very interesting, he's full of real good ideas and hints and tips. And so I'll put a link to his channel in the description box and while we're checking out. But he done a video recently where he was talking. He's one of these guys that does walk the walk. So I think he's an outdoors instructor, bushcraft instructor, and he spends a lot of time out. And these are the people you want to be following to get good honest tips, people that actually do walk the walk and not just talk the walk, so to speak. But anyway, I brought out with me my, it's called an Arctic bag, but it's not really an Arctic bag. It's rated to about minus 10, comfort probably about zero. But what Neil did, he put his air mattress, in this case it's an Alp Kit cloud base, and that's what he was using, actually inside the bag. Now this is a thin pad, and the idea is that with it in the bag it doesn't move around, and it's much more comfortable, and also it's protected from punches even more so. And you need a large bag. I got a large size bag, and that gives me plenty of room for me and the Thermarest, or as I say, the Alp Kit cloud base. Let's get this inflated and I'll show you what he does. So that's the pad inflated. Push the pad into the bottom of the sleeping bag. A bit of an awkward job, but it will fit. Right to the foot end it wants to go. So these bags, to work properly, they need to be used in a modular fashion. So inside that, I'll be using a nice silk liner, that's nice and warm. That adds a couple of degrees for warmth. And the bag itself now goes inside the Gore-Tex bivy, and this creates a microclimate around the bag. This also means that I don't need the inner in my tent, so that also has a knock-on effect. It gives me more space and more room in the tent to enjoy the evening. This now goes into the tent, and it rests on top of a closed cell phone mat, so you've got several layers of protection between you and the ground, and so has the internal inflatable sleeping mat. So my idea is to roll it up like this and leave it in the corner of the shelter, and then unroll it when I want to go to bed. Temperatures are falling now, sun's gone down. It's time to get that stove going. Am I going to cheat? Nothing wrong with a bit of cheating. I've got plenty of lamp oil, kerosene, so a little bit of that. And that'll be a good starter for the fire. I'll put a bit of wood in there first, I think, to get a couple of pieces of wood in there as a base. Get some twigs in there.
luckily there was lots of twigs on the ground at the moment. Recent storms we've had blew a lot of loose stuff down, so I don't think I'll have any problem with kindling, getting this fire going. Easy as that. Well, it's time to sit back and relax for a little bit. I've just had an amazing sunset. There's hardly a cloud in the sky. So later on I hope to get my GoPro and do a time lapse of the stars. Should be a good one. And I'm just about to prepare my meal. I'm having a good old piece of circle. Stove popping and banging, a good one, that's that pine. Yeah, I got a piece of sirloin steak, I got some sprouts, some potatoes, eggs for the morning, Jaffa cakes, I love Jaffa cakes, that'll be for later on. Let's get the evening meal prepped. Stove is whacking some heat out, I tell you. That pine burns really hot. Try and throttle it back a little bit. Well, there's a steak. Done perfect. Absolutely perfect. Sprout, lovely. Crispy potato cubes. Well, sort of sauteed. This is very nice. Lovely. That was very nice. And washed down with a nice brew dog. Bit fizzy this one, bit lively. Crikey. Cheers. Temperature's dropping, I tell you, I've got the door open at the moment. I'm still quite pleasantly warm in here, but I can feel the cold, chilly air, Arctic air, coming in through the door. So I'll be closing the door soon, but time now to enjoy some Jaffa cakes. I've got the door closed now, keeping all the nice warmth in. It's beginning to warm up in here, lovely. Just time to put my slippers on. I'm surprised at how well this wood is burning, actually, this pine. I didn't think it was going to be that good because it's very light stuff, but it's lovely and dry despite all the wet weather we've had recently. And this is the last piece I'm going to put on now, and the rest of them I'm going to save them for tomorrow. So I think I'm going to need the stove on first thing to take the chill off the place. It's going to be -8 with the wind chill overnight, so let's put this last piece on. A bit of the information I gathered is that when you stack wood at home, or you store your wood, you want to store it that way round. Apparently the rain or if it hits it, then just runs off of it. But when you burn it, you want to burn it that way round. I don't know how true that is. I wonder if anyone else has Heard that before. Anyway, let's put the last piece on. And it's now time to get the sleeping system set out. Well, now about 7:15 in the morning. I've slept reasonably well, actually. Although you can notice now the mat is actually underneath the sleeping bag and not actually in the sleeping bag like it was when I started the night off. I found that for me it was just too constrictive. Not enough room in the sleeping bag. Maybe I need a larger sleeping bag for that system to work. But what it did do, it did keep the mat close to my body, and you can't slide off the mat, whereas with the mat like this underneath it all, you can slide off of it. And in fact I did, I went back to sleep and I woke up sometime later and I found I was lying diagonally across the mat and I wasn't benefiting at all from this mat. So for me, Neil's system wasn't as effective as I was hoping it would be. But then that's me personally, you know, we're all different, aren't we? I'm a bit of a cold sleeper, I think. This mat also hasn't got an R value. It's a cloud base by Alp Kit, and it's brilliant in the summertime, but I don't think it's a bit very good for winter camping. Need to upgrade it. Anyway, time to get the fire going. Bit of condensation. Bit of condensation in here, so the heat from the stove would drive all that away. pepper. Not such a bad breakfast after all. Mmm. Bit hot. I think it's still good to have a stove when you come hot, when you come hot tent camping, to have a wood stove, but also a secondary form of cooking, because sometimes the wood stove it has a lower even temperature, but it doesn't have that vigorous sort of heat to boil stuff or cook stuff really quick. So that's why I done my coffee on the gas stove. It's also nice to sit in a warm tent. Normally I pack up in the morning, just get out of the woods quick and get home. But I'm not going to be in any hurry today. I thought I'd just light the stove. You can see the condensation still on the, sort of from here on upwards it's dry, but going back it's damp still, so stove hopefully will dry some of that away.